Today I'm going to show you how to do that flicker effect, not only with images, but with text as well. Let's get right to it.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
In Filmora, I already have a piece of footage I shot of a burger. It's actually a reverse speed ramp with a dissolve at the end. If you want to know how to pull that effect off, let me know in the comments. Let's drag our diner sign to the picture-in-picture track and adjust the length. I want it to appear just after the burger comes into focus and disappear right before that clip ends. Let's resize it and put it up in the corner. Maybe a little angle could be cool too. Now, let's grab our neon burger text and drag that into our timeline. Notice that Filmora understands that I'm adding more video files, so it automatically creates another picture-in-picture track. Now let's resize that and put it inside of our diner sign frame. There we go. Next, I want to create that flicker effect with the sign, so I'm going to find a few spots to cut that track up and leave some spaces in between. When we play the track, these spaces will make the text appear and disappear rapidly, as if the neon is turning on and off or flickering. Let's remove the excess at the end so it's the same length as a diner sign frame and take a look. Pretty cool. Looks kind of like a flickering neon sign. What will really sell this is if we can put some audio underneath it. I searched the YouTube audio library and they didn't have any sort of electric crackling sound effect, but they did have a few other free sound effects that I think I can layer together to create the sound I want. I was able to find this power tool buzzing clip. I also was able to find this one, which was static coming from a small tweeter speaker. And last, I found this clip of electric hair clippers. Not that I would know anything about having my hair cut. I bet these will layer together nicely. Let's drag them into the timeline. I've added some extra audio tracks to accommodate these sound files. Let's get them all sized to match our flickering neon sign. Next, let's click on the top audio clip and hold Ctrl button on our keyboard while clicking the other two. This will allow us to work with all three audio clips at the same time. Let's slice them exactly where the neon burger image is edited and create the same flicker spacing to the sound that we did in our text image. We can either slice and drag these clips or we could cut them and delete the pieces. I find that cutting and sliding them all together is faster, but that's just a personal preference. Once we have all of our slices aligned and in place, let's trim the ends to match the length of the sign footage. I'll make a few adjustments to the volumes of each sound effect clip to help them blend together to what I think sounds like a neon sign flickering. If you click right on the image of the little faders, an audio mixer comes up and we can mix the independent volumes of each track, as well as the overall volume of the mix. I'll just turn down the louder of the audio clips and get them to blend together a bit, and let's see what we have. Boom, there we go, a cool flicker effect, and you can use these for titles or images or video clips exactly the same way we did with these clips. Always remember that sound really helps out some of these effects, and I'll be covering how to do more with your audio in the future. But until then, do me a favor, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and I promise you, we'll continue this conversation. Peace.